to have the modern S-500 missile system today. Soviet missiles have undergone more than half a century of development and upgrade. Over time, the missile defense systems of the Soviet Union and Russia have proven their strength, becoming the nemesis of armed fighters. After the Second World War, with the advancement in military aviation and the emergence of jet-powered aircraft, our anti-aircraft artillery could not secure troops and civilian targets from air strikes. In August 1950, the Soviet leadership decided to create an air defense system using missiles without using artillery and would have an advanced radar network. The person in charge of this division was Marshal Lavrenty Beria. The new anti-aircraft missile system was called Berkut. It is interesting that the main designer of the project, Mr. Berkut, is the son of Marshal Lavrenty Beria. Berkut is also known as S-25. NATO reporting name is SA-1 Geared. S-25 stands for Systema 25, refers to the entire missile system, radar and launchers. Parts of the system include the V-300 missile, the R-113 and B-200 radar, and the A-11, A-12 antenna for the B-200. The S-25 can hit targets at a speed of 1,500 km per hour at an altitude of 20 km, with a maximum range of 35 km. According to many military experts, the Berkut air defense system in the 1950s was the most advanced air defense system. Launched at the dawn of a missile era, it was clear that the Berkut anti-aircraft missile system has certain shortcomings. First, the Berkut anti-aircraft missile system was very expensive to build and maintain. Accordingly, only Moscow had the financial capacity to cover the complex of the missile system. Even because of the high costs, plans to build a missile complex to defend Leningrad were cut, not to mention other Soviet cities. Second, the Berkut anti-aircraft missile system was not maneuverable. This disadvantage made it a great target for enemy aircraft in the event of an armed conflict. Third, the Berkut anti-aircraft missile system was designed to deal with bombers, but when it came into service, the bomber tactic changed. The bombers operated in small units, making it more difficult to destroy. Despite its shortcomings, the Berkut missile system for several decades was believed to protect the Soviet capital's skies, even until the 1980s. It was not until 30 years after being built that Berkut was replaced from the payroll of the Soviet Air Defense Forces. To overcome the shortcomings of the missile system, Soviet engineers developed a mobile air defense missile system. Manufacturing work began in 1953. and the mobile S-75 air defense system was born, developed on the basis of the Berkut air defense system. The S-75 used V-750 missiles. In addition, the large part SM-63 and the transport vehicle PR-11 were developed. In 1957, the S-75 air defense system entered service. The S-75 was born to ensure the mobility of the air defense system and to reduce production and maintenance costs. During the Cold War, the Soviet Union exported this air defense system to Algeria, Vietnam, Egypt, Iraq, Libya, Yugoslavia, Syria, and many other countries. Throughout its history, the S-75 air defense system has been involved in many conflicts, including the Vietnam War, the Arab-Israeli War, and the Persian Gulf War. Arguably, the S-75 has proven to be a very powerful weapon. During the Vietnam War, certain flaws of the S-75 were revealed. By 1968, to destroy a single target, between 12 and 15 missiles would be required, which increases costs. In addition, the number of missiles dropped due to not hitting the target was also increased, resulting in ground losses. At the time, however, the S-75 was still a truly advanced air defense system. From the 1980s onwards, there were many new improvements to the missile. The S-25 and S-75 were replaced by the S-125, S-200, S-300, and S-400 air defense systems. And today, the S-500 is Russia's most modern anti-aircraft missile system. My video about S-25 Berkut missile answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.